परम शांति। टुडे वी विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट वन ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक, आकाशिक रिकॉर्ड्स। देर इज़ अ सीरीज इन यूट्यूब नेम्ड एज एंशिएंट एलियंस, वेयर दे टॉक अबाउट द आकाशिक रिकॉर्ड्स, विच इज़ अ स्टोर हाउस ऑफ ऑल रिकॉर्ड्स ऑफ द सोलर सिस्टम। इट सीम्स टू बी रियली मिस्टिकल एंड ऑल्सो क्वाइट एन अननोन टॉपिक फॉर अ कॉमन पब्लिक। इन दिस वीडियो बापूजी हैज एक्सप्लेन्ड द रियलिटी अबाउट Akashic records and how these records are stored. Akashic records definitely exist, meaning all records of a solar system are stored with its creator known as Paramatma Parameshwar Shiv in incorporeal form known as Nirakari Shiv, residing in supreme abode or Paramdham of the solar system. The records of each and every event of the solar system, including records of each and every soul, lies with the Shiv, the creator of the solar system. Similarly, Mahashiv, the creator of a galaxy, around whom trillions and trillions of solar systems revolve, has the records of all solar systems of a galaxy. Now, scientists have discovered a white light at the center of a galaxy. In fact, it is a supreme abode of Mahashiv known as Mahaparamdham, where all data of trillions of solar system is recorded. Similarly, all the information of trillions and trillions of galaxies reaches to the creator of universe, that is Param Mahashiv. A universe contains infinite galaxies and all records of these galaxies get stored in the supreme abode of universe where Param Mahashiv resides. In this manner, records of infinite universe is stored in great universe. Records of infinite great universes is stored in great great universe, and so on. Ultimately, all the records of the vast infinite boundless creation get stored in the highest supreme abode of supreme power, the almighty authority known as Behad Ki Kala Ka Paramdham. That means every event in this creation is recorded and never goes unnoticed by its creator. So almighty authority has all records right from a small planet like Earth to the highest dimension of creation known as Behad Ki Kala Ka Paramdham. Generally, in physical world, the intellectuals used words like consciousness to represent power of soul. There are various levels of consciousness. The scientists say that celestial consciousness is different from physical consciousness. The celestial consciousness contains the records and history of creation. Now, scientists are revealing all such facts, which is a domain of spiritual knowledge. In order to understand the concept of celestial consciousness, we must consider the solar system as explained by Bapuji. The solar system has 14 layers of creation, with upper 7 layers and lower 7 layers. Upper 7 layers start from Bhulok and ends at Brahmalok or Satyalok, and lower 7 loks ends at Patallok. Above the Brahmalok, there is Vishnupuri, then Shivpuri, and finally Paramdham. Each layer represents a particular dimension of creation inside a solar system, and this creation in each dimension is made up of elements of that layer. The creative power of elements of any layer or dimension of creation depends on the power of a soul residing in that dimension and vice versa. The degree of power in any dimension of creation is known as consciousness of that layer of creation. So consciousness is nothing but the combined power of souls in that particular dimension. The records of any particular dimension is stored the atoms of elements which represents the consciousness or power of that layer of creation. For example, every atom of air on this earth has certain power on which the earth survives. Once this power is exhausted, then creations on earth cannot sustain. This is the consciousness of this earth, which is now quite low, but as we go up in higher dimensions, the level of consciousness will increase, which is represented as divine energy as well. Similarly, as we go higher, the power, purity and fineness of elements increases, known as supreme elements or Param Tattva. So creation in higher dimensions is more powerful than that of lower dimensions. Shiv resides in the supreme abode of a solar system. Mahashiv resides in the supreme abode of a galaxy. Paramahashiv resides in the supreme abode of universe and so on. Supreme abode is the highest dimension of creation with the highest level of consciousness. From there onwards, the energy level or consciousness decreases as we go into the lower dimensions. This change in consciousness from Paramdham to lower dimensions is same for all, be it a solar system or galaxy or universe. The energy of a solar system emerges from the energy of its creator Shiv. Similarly, each micro constituent of a galaxy has the power of Mahashiv. This is the law of creation. The energy of creator is embedded in a very subtle way in each element. If element is refined, then we find atoms. If atom is refined, then we find protons, neutrons, etc., known as subatomic particles. If protons and neutrons are further refined, then we find very fine subatomic particles like boson, quark, etc., as described in the language of science. In fact, all these are not particles but energy forms with different frequencies. Even scientists are also carrying out research work on all these subjects known as quantum physics. So, energy of creator is stored in very subtle manner in those subtle particles of elements. This energy is known as consciousness. This energy of creator flows from Paramdham to the lowest level of creation and gets stored in the elements of respective dimensions depending on purity and fineness of elements. Every celestial body in space contains the energy of its creator. However, this energy is not same everywhere. It changes inside a celestial body as explained just now. Each celestial body has many dimensions of creation inside it, like 14 layers in a Brahmand. The consciousness at every level is different. Accordingly, consciousness of souls at each level of creation is also different. All this information is stored in the form of electromagnetic waves in the Akashic records, which is not visible to a human eye. A new word has been coined to explain Akashic record, known as cloud computing. This whole earth is covered by a hidden network of electromagnetic waves, which is known as cloud. This cloud network records data and transmits data through different technologies that we come across in our daily lives as mobile, internet, TV channels, etc. Through this cloud computing technology, data is sent to satellites revolving around Earth, and from there the data is spread around the world in different bandwidths. There is a temple of sage Narad in Raichur. As per our Hindu scriptures, there are many sages like Naraji who could easily access the information of any layer of our Brahmand from Earth or from higher dimensions. They could also travel to any layers of creation in their invisible subtle form. Particularly Narad, who was famous for traveling anywhere in 14 layers of our Brahmand. Naraji's name is mentioned in many Hindu scriptures, including epics like Mahabharata and Ramayana. Narad Puran is based on stories of Naraji. Narad could travel from Patal Lok to Vishnu Lok, meaning from lowest level to a highest level of creation in our Brahmand. He was a frequent traveler between different layers, as Narad was a messenger of Vishnu. Narad could see any records of any lower dimensions from Brahmalok. He had the powers to know the past, present, future events. So he used to travel to Patal Lok, Bhulok, Swarglok, etc. to give messages to the affected souls and help them to take appropriate actions. Naraji was considered to be famous for instigating conflicts between deities and demons. Even Brahma, Vishnu and Shankar were not spared for this. But his main aim was to transmit the message of Vishnu for the benevolence of this creation. It is also told that Narad could access data of any dimensions wherever and whenever he used to travel in the solar system. Mostly he used to stay in Brahmalok, where one day is equivalent to 1000 Chaturyug on earth. So difference in conscious level of earth and Brahmalok is very huge, due to which the time cycle is so different in both the layers. Narad was a subtle creation of Brahma's mind, so he had power to observe all the activities of all layers below Brahmalok, like Taplok, Mahalok, our own earth, and down to Patal Lok as well. So Narad was very powerful sage, also known as Trikaldarshi, having the knowledge of past, present and future. Bapuji has explained how data is transferred and what are the limitations of electromagnetic waves. All activities going on earth are recorded in the elements of earth. These records are gradually transferred to higher dimensions through the subtle vibrations in energy form. These energy magnetic waves have limitations, as they cannot travel to higher dimensions. Any information which spreads on earth is done through EM waves with different bandwidths. For example, the information received through YouTube on the internet has a particular bandwidth or frequency range. Information through TV has different frequency. By changing channels on TV, the frequency range is further changed. Information in radio or mobile has other frequency range. The bandwidth or EM wave of EM wave, which is being used on Earth for transmitting information, that same EM wave cannot travel to higher dimensions. Thus, records stored in elements on Earth cannot be transferred to different layers of creation. As mentioned earlier, about 14 layers of a creation in our solar system by EM wave. Discussion on Narad is a lengthy topic and requires long time. In ancient times, the sages achieved subtle powers by raising their consciousness levels through meditation. The word soul appears for a first time in Srimad Bhagavad Gita. Prior to it, the word consciousness was used to indicate the power of a soul. Through activities like penance and meditation, the sages would raise their consciousness to a very high level. Their divine vision or third eye could be awakened through pure soul consciousness, enabling them to see the past, present and future of any event in higher dimension away from this earth. The power of soul increases by realization of soul consciousness. A soul can connect with higher dimensions by its awakened consciousness, that is increased level energy level of a soul. Since the sages had very high level of consciousness, they could travel to higher dimensions and also could access those dimensions information easily. Soul has tremendous power, but it has to be awakened through rigorous spiritual practice. Sages would chant the name of their chosen deity, known as Ishtadev, such as Om Namah Shivaya, and live in the forest for meditation while being in seclusion. Continuous chanting of mantras for their deities in meditative state made the sages to forget their body, resulting in the awakening of their soul power, which is nothing but increasing the level of consciousness. This increase in consciousness bestowed many subtle powers to sages, including sage Narad. In pure soul consciousness, the divine vision get awakened, which we call third eye. Through this vision of third eye, the sages could take their consciousness up to the level of Swarglok, whereas Mahadev could see all the events of this Brahmand through his divine vision of his third eye. That is why Mahadev is also called Trinetra. Similarly, Brahma Rishi had higher ranges of divine vision up to Brahmalok, since they can raise their consciousness even beyond Swarglok, which is more powerful than normal sages. If a soul on earth can raise its consciousness up to the level of Shiv Nirakari in Paramdham, then soul can access all data of this Paramdham. If consciousness can be raised to the level of Mahashiv, then all data of galaxy can be accessed. If consciousness can be raised to the level of Paramahashiv, then all the data of universe can be accessed. In this way, if consciousness can be raised to the level of almighty authority, then all the data of this infinite boundless creation can be accessed. Babuji has said that presently there are different categories of souls present on earth. Some are from galaxies, some are from universe, and some from multiverses, etc. In the video Journey of Soul, this has been explained in detail. Due to which many religions have been established on earth. Now earth is a place of multi-religion. Due to the existence of various categories of soul on earth. So if a soul who has come from galaxy has realized the pure soul consciousness and the power of its soul, then this soul on earth can raise its consciousness up to the level of galaxy and can access the data of galaxy. Now science is also accepting the fact that Akashic records cannot be accessed by any physical means but only through spiritual power by raising the level of consciousness. So each and every data of this Brahmand is stored in the Akashic records with tiniest detailing. Aliens can use these data in Akashic records for their benefits. Babuji here explains about aliens and their power. Who are aliens? The souls from different galaxies, universes, great-great universes are known as aliens. Babuji has explained about them that these souls are very powerful as they are from higher dimensions. They have already captured many planets in the solar system. These souls are in a category of Mahashiv, Paramahashiv, hence they are much powerful than the souls of this Brahmand. Aliens are very powerful as compared to ghosts and souls of the subtle world of this Brahmand. They can access all records of this Brahmand and they can read the minds of people on earth. The messengers or paigambar, religious fathers who have been coming to earth from time to time to preach their religions on earth have also given many prophecies on earth. They are actually human incarnation of souls from distant galaxies, universes, etc. And they were all accompanied by souls of the subtle world having a three elemental body. The souls of subtle world transmit the messages through inspirations to messengers or paigambar. By sending signals through subtle vibrations, these souls would transmit the information about subtle world including the happenings of future events. Hence, any kind of supernatural power exhibits by such messengers was nothing but inspirations from souls of subtle world who have accompanied that human souls on earth. Thus, the foretelling of future or any prophecies by anyone on the earth is not due to reading of Akashic records. Now science also explains that if a soul raises the consciousness of its mind up to the level of Akashic records, then he or she can access all data in those Akashic records. There are many categories of souls on earth like general worldly souls, powerful souls from galaxy, universe, multiverse, etc. and behad souls, that is infinite boundless souls. If a soul such as Behad soul acquires supreme knowledge and raises soul consciousness, then it can access the Akashic records. Lower category worldly souls cannot do this as they cannot understand this knowledge. In fact, they will not even listen to a supreme knowledge. When a soul silences its mind by various spiritual practices like chanting name of deities, penance, meditation, etc., it is only going to help in preventing the loss of power of its own soul. But that does not mean it is powerful enough to raise its consciousness and gain access of Akashic records. In pure soul consciousness, a powerful soul can know who its creator is and the category to which the soul belongs to. In pure soul consciousness, the soul connects with its creator like Shiv, Mahashiv or Paramahashiv or even Almighty Authority and receive powers from them. Then the soul can access Akashic records of Shiv, Mahashiv or Paramahashiv depending on its level of attainment. Here two points are important. First, one is the realization of pure soul consciousness and second, connecting with higher power through yoga. Nothing is possible without achieving the state of soul consciousness. If a soul connects with deities, God, goddesses, etc., then they also it cannot access any Akashic records. Only when it connects with the Almighty Authority, it is able to receive tremendous power, allowing it to access all data of Akashic records of this vast infinite creation. Through Akashic records, a soul can get the knowledge of past, present, and future. Records automatically get registered in every atoms of creation as soon as the event takes place. Even a grain of sand on earth has records to convey to the souls of this world. So at every level, the records are stored in all atoms of elements. At present, 198 crore years of second parad of Brahma has finished, and before that, first parad, that is, first 50 years of Brahma had been completed. The earth was created in first parad after the elapse of a period of 10 years of Brahma's life. So till now, earth has seen 40 years of Brahma and 198 crore human years, that is approximately 130 trillion human years, which is huge time period in human scale. So each atom of the earth has records of events of 130 trillion years since the formation of earth. The records are embedded in the form of vibrations in each atom of all five elements on earth. In the path of devotion, it is said that God resides in each atom of creation. That means records of each atom is also with God, the Creator. Each cell of a human body contains records, but since the soul has lost its power, it cannot access any records stored in its body cell. Every cell of the atmosphere keeps all records. If a soul awakens to its power, it can access the records and become knowledgeable. All knowledge is derived from the atoms of the atmosphere only. Even what we see in TV or internet is the transmission of the data from various strata of atmosphere. So whole knowledge of Earth lies in its atmosphere only. Each and every atom of the atmosphere is full of knowledge. A scientist named Irwin Laszlo in 2004 published a book wherein he mentioned about invisible Akashic fields containing all records of cosmos. As per Laszlo, the Akashic field is comprised of quantum waves and the entire cosmos is filled with matrix of quantum waves. These quantum waves are present all around us, but we cannot see them. So now scientists are also realizing the existence of invisible field where data is stored. Now human souls on earth are in body consciousness, so their range of vibration can only travel short distances and can only detect physical objects. So a normal human soul cannot feel the presence of these subtle quantum waves around them. When a soul realizes pure soul consciousness, then its vibration can travel to higher dimensions of the solar system and even beyond the solar system to the levels of galaxy too. Earlier sages had power to feel the energy fields of higher dimensions by raising their level of consciousness. Scientists are also telling that Akashic records are no longer superstition or based on blind beliefs. Rather, they have strong proof of existence of Akashic fields in which every data of cosmos is stored. According to Bapuji, before scientists could detect these subtle world in true sense, spiritual science will evolve at a very fast pace and these physical scientists will be replaced by spiritual scientists, which Bapuji has already told in their video New Future World. A very famous physicist named as Richard Feynman has written a book on quantum physics named as A Strange Theory of Light and Matter, in which he has mentioned that electrons of brain cells can be activated by using quantum waves through which the thoughts of mind as well as subconscious mind can be modulated. In quantum field, data can be transmitted within no time between subatomic particles which are far away from each other. So vibration of a far away subatomic particle can be affected by changing the vibration of any subatomic particle anywhere in the quantum field. Each electron in brain cells work as a signal receiver which can catch waves of different frequencies in quantum field. Through this quantum field, aliens contact human species on Earth. By using this technique, quantum field's future can also be predicted. This has explained by Feynman in his book. Bapuji has explained all these findings of scientists in terms of supreme knowledge. These subatomic particles or electrons are subtle waves generated in human mind. Subtle waves are comprised of various orientations of electrons depending on its energy level or frequency of vibration. From where are these electrons getting energy to orient or to behave in a particular manner? It is from soul itself. As per spiritual knowledge, mind is present inside a soul. So, with the power of soul, electrons of mind gets activated and oriented in such a manner that it matches with the frequency of vibrations of higher dimensions. Hence, a soul can connect with higher dimensions and can access all information from there. But for all this to materialize, a soul requires power to activate the electrons of brain cells to the level of frequencies of higher dimensions. So when soul gets power, all the bandwidths of frequencies are accessed in brain through electrons, so all the records from galaxy, universe, multiverse can be accessed. One can even recognize the true form of almighty authority if a soul receives sufficient power and is energized to the level of highest dimensions where almighty authority resides. When true power of soul gets awakened, then third eye open up, and then soul can do whatever it wants with its power. There is a person named as Baba Venga who has become blind since her childhood in an accident. After becoming blind, she got the power of forecasting future. Now she is a famous in the name of Baba Venga. She has made many prophecies which have come true. She can even see the future of any person through her mind, similar to how pictures are displayed on a screen. Whether Baba Venga has power to access the data of Akashic records through which she is foretelling the future events that are going to occur? Bapuji has explained here this phenomena of forecasting future by some souls on earth at present time. Bapuji has said that any supernatural or superhuman activity displayed by any spiritual master or any religious father or any messenger or even any scientist, it is possible only with the help of souls from the subtle world. So these spiritual masters or messengers or religious fathers are always accompanied by thousands of souls from subtle world. No human soul on earth has any power to manifest any miracle. Through inspiration, these thousands of souls of subtle world transmit the message to the mind of spiritual master or messenger or prophets, and according to them they make all the type of prophecies based on the messages they get from souls of a subtle world. Three elemental souls in the subtle world can access the data of subtle world, so they know the future of physical world from these data. But the prophecies of the messengers, prophets, spiritual masters are not always 100% correct, but they can be correct up to 50 to 60%. When a solar system is created, then its script is written, just like the script of a drama. So the souls in a subtle world can access those scripts and engage in making forecasting based on these data. With the progress of time, the script also changes, so the prophecies cannot be always 100% correct. So these prophets cannot access the data of Akashic records, but with the help of inspirations from souls of subtle world, all the prophecies are made. Baba Venga has told that she has been in the connection with extraterrestrial entities and can see them as a glow of light in water. She is blind person, but she can see through her mind. These extraterrestrial entities or aliens usually tells Baba Venga about many secrets which are found in the scriptures of different religions. How this phenomena can be explained in spiritual knowledge. Bapuji has said that sages mentioned in Hindu scripture could connect with higher dimensions of creations of this Brahmand from earth. There are plenty of examples for that, but one is mentioned here. Markandeya Rishi used to observe dance of damsels in Brahmalok from earth. But these prophets or messengers can only predict future based on the messages that they have received from souls in subtle world through inspiration, and they do not have any power to access the Akashic records. The video of the same is available in Hindi. Please check the link in the description box. Thank you so much. Behad ki Paramaha Shanti.